It looks like Blue Origin is hiding something about New Glenn. They just scrubbed for the second time for a very weird reason. Hey, I'm Lucas. Welcome to the SpaceX community. Let's get started. The eagerly awaited second flight of New Glenn, the NG2 mission operated by Blue Origin, was once again scrubbed, this time attributing the call-off to a confluence of terrestrial weather, sea state concerns, a stray cruise ship in the exclusion zone, and elevated solar activity. The mission, which was to carry ESCAPADE, twin spacecraft for NASA, along with a rideshare communications demonstration from Viasat into deep space, had been targeted for liftoff on November 9th, 2025, but didn't get off the pad. On the scheduled day, the countdown stretched through an 88-minute window, but heavy cumulus cloud cover over the launch pad at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station prevented clearance. Meanwhile, on the ground system side, teams reported a hold at around T-minus 17 minutes for what was described as an LVHD retraction issue, likely a tower arm or umbilical retraction fault. And a cruise ship entered the designated exclusion zone downrange, complicating range safety. Given those problems, plus the range of environmental constraints, the decision to scrub was taken at about 4:19 p.m. ET. But the complications didn't end there. A subsequent planned attempt on November 12th was also called off. This time, because of elevated solar activity. According to Blue Origin, NASA made the call to stand down due to highly elevated solar activity and its potential effects on the ESCAPADE spacecraft. The NOAA Space Weather Prediction Center had issued a G4 severe geomagnetic storm watch tied to a coronal mass ejection arriving midday, noting this was just the fourth such watch this solar cycle. Thus, in effect, the second launch of New Glenn has been scrubbed twice. Once for weather, ground system, and ship intruder reasons, and again, due to space weather. This sequence of delays is troubling for Blue Origin. Not because delays are unheard of in launch campaigns, but because some of the reasons are arguably avoidable and raise questions about execution, range coordination, and robustness, especially when the company is positioning New Glenn as a heavy-lift reusable vehicle designed to challenge the incumbent. To step back, New Glenn's development itself has been protracted. The vehicle was originally announced years ago, and its debut, NG1, ultimately flew in January 2025 after several slips. That first flight marked Blue Origin's first orbital mission, achieving orbit and deploying its payload, but importantly, it failed in its first stage booster landing attempt. The first stage, named So You're Telling Me There's a Chance, did not relight its BE-4 engines for the re-entry burn and was lost at sea. The Federal Aviation Administration investigation into that landing mishap concluded in March 2025 and identified 7 corrective actions for Blue Origin, focusing on propellant management and engine bleed control. So on the one hand, the company successfully demonstrated the core capability of reaching orbit on its first try, a non-trivial milestone. On the other hand, the booster recovery objective remains unfulfilled, and now NG2 is being delayed, not purely for rocket performance, but for ancillary issues: weather, range intruder, sea state, solar storm, that are perhaps less within the direct control of the vehicle system, but nonetheless part of the operational risk profile. From the external perspective, the narrative is uncomfortable. A high-profile, heavy-lift rocket, developed with great fanfare and capital, targets reuse and market competitiveness, yet at this moment, its second flight is being delayed for a complex cocktail of reasons. Potential customers, investors, and competitors will be watching and forming opinions. Excuses such as a stray cruise ship, cumulus clouds, sea state too high, and solar storm may all be valid. But when strung together, they can present the impression of fragility or lack of operational maturity. Contrast this with the pace of SpaceX and its workhorse Falcon 9. And increasingly, the Starship. SpaceX is routinely launching, landing, and reflying boosters with high cadence and reliability, iterating rapidly along the way. Booster landings on Falcon 9 have become almost mundane, a remarkable turnaround from earlier years. The commercial launch market and governmental customers now expect reliable cadence, reuse economics, and minimal excuses. In that context, Blue Origin's current sequence, despite legitimate external reasons, risks damaging the impression that they are fully ready to play in that game. Moreover, Blue Origin is aiming high. New Glenn is designed for heavy lift, is reusable, and has contracts with NASA, ESCAPADE for Mars magnetosphere study, and ambitions for lunar missions and commercial geostationary launches. Delays and mishaps undermine that trajectory. The market will note that many of Blue Origin's competitors launched smaller vehicles and established reuse earlier, SpaceX being the prominent example. And now, Blue Origin is chasing at scale. When that chase stalls for reasons beyond the direct rocket hardware, such as range intruders, weather rules, or solar storms, the optics are that the ecosystem isn't entirely under control. Of course, it would be unreasonable to expect perfect launches in the early days of any heavy-lift reusable vehicle. New Glenn is large, 321 feet tall, featuring a first-stage recovery at sea, BE-4 engines, and reusability for up to 25 flights initially. The longer development time may reflect the technical ambition. But the flip side is that when you emerge late and expect to compete, the margin for excuse is lower. Every delay resonates. Blue Origin's public communications also matter. Some media coverage notes that Blue Origin called off the launch due to poor weather, and later due to elevated solar activity. In isolation, each statement is plausible. In aggregate, the stream of external dependencies highlights that the campaign execution has many moving pieces. Not entirely surprising, but leaves less room for the narrative of seamless readiness. For a space company trying to signal that it will be a reliable provider of heavy lift and reusable flights, the impression that the next launch window is no earlier than some later date, with multiple external scrubs, invites caution among potential customers. In that regard, the failed booster landing on the inaugural flight continues to loom large. Although the mission achieved orbit, reuse recovery is a cornerstone of the business model. If booster recovery remains elusive, the cost equation worsens, reuse economics weaken, and the ability to compete with SpaceX's reuse-proven Falcon 9, and soon Falcon Heavy and Starship, is diminished. Even though Blue Origin has identified corrective actions, and the FAA cleared the vehicle for its next flight, the clock is ticking. Meanwhile, SpaceX has repeatedly demonstrated rapid turnaround, high cadence, booster reuse, and multiple landings and reflights. That experience gives SpaceX credibility and a customer base that already expects reliability and logistics. For Blue Origin, the story is still. We reached orbit, yes, but we haven't yet recovered the booster, and the second flight is delayed. That gap creates space for customers to delay contracts or choose known providers rather than risk being early with New Glenn. Looking ahead, what matters is when Blue Origin can actually fly NG2, recover the booster, and then fly again quickly, thereby shifting from "we had issues" to "we are in production." That shift will do much to repair the impression if instead the delays continue, even if innocuous. The narrative may harden. This is still a very challenging development, and operational readiness is further off than hoped. In conclusion, the double scrub of New Glenn's second flight is more than just a scheduling nuisance. It underlines the multiple operational dependencies and the delicate choreography of vehicle, ground systems, range, weather, and space weather. While Blue Origin has made real technical progress and achieved a successful orbit on NG-1, the booster landing failure and now the drawn-out tempo of NG-2 threatens the company's impression of readiness. In a commercial landscape where SpaceX has already set the clock ticking at high cadence, Blue Origin must move swiftly from delays and explanations to rapid launches and recoveries. The next few months will be pivotal, both for the vehicle and for the company's standing. Thanks for watching today's episode. Don't forget to subscribe and give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Stay tuned for another great video tomorrow.